John Kilduff here of Let's Pay TV. We got a special event here today. We have Karen Centerfold as Lolita, as our guest portrait artist that we're gonna paint. We have Jeff from Frozen Plastic over here with the music vibes, in-house band. And we're gonna have a wonderful time getting down, getting the paint down, and dealing with our fears with painting, and just get that brush on the canvas and get going. You gotta get going. Moving, moving, moving. Got to get keep on moving. Rawhide. Said it wrong, whatever. Okay, so anyway, welcome everybody. A little white stripes. What is that, frozen stripes?
White stripes.
White stripes. We broke it up.
A little
changed things up here,
band,
you know, sometimes. And of course, Karen Centerfold as Lolita.
Yeah.
Oh my God, what are we doing here?
I'll take it all off later.
All right. That's what we like to hear on Let's Paint TV. To be free and get in there and get painting. That's what we want to do, encourage you to paint. Now, if we're offending you, any of you out there, well, just turn the channel and watch somebody else taking their clothes off, because there's plenty of it out there. All right, so this is a painting show, so let's just get right on to it, all right?
Yeah.
Big brush, that's what we like to do, right? So with that big brush, big fat 2-inch brush, we're gonna just go right in there into my juice can, which is paint thinner, okay? Just paint thinner, odorless paint thinner though, so it doesn't stink. Here we go. Ignite the canvas. We like to talk about this all the time, ignite this canvas, Karen, and what we're trying to say is it breaks, it already we've just jumped into the deep end. We've just jumped in the water, and the water is cold. Okay, well my easel is needs to be tightened. So a little technical difficulties here. You might have seen, we've seen you on, you have your own cable show, don't you?
Yeah, the Raw Talent Rock and Roll Live Hour, where I put all the best LA local bands on, right?
Cool.
And I ask them a bunch of rock questions, drug questions, and they play, right?
Okay.
They don't know that much about art, though, because they're too
right.
busy taking drugs, fighting with each other over
right.
money, over position,
right.
the one lead guitar wants another drummer, that type of thing, right?
Right.
But if they did do what you're doing, John,
yeah.
right, they could get their minds off their
off.
Problems,
right.
their selfish ways, right?
Right.
And their greedy ways, and the dope they do, too much
right.
whiskey, too much pity, and they can make a good painting.
Right.
Right?
Well, what's keeping me is I'm trying to look for this little thing, a screwdriver.
Got it?
Yeah. We'll just have to go without it. I'm going to be on the shakes. It's going to vibrate or something. Do we have a screw? You guys have a screwdriver? Gus, go. Gus might have a screwdriver. But this is live to tape. We can't stop, you know what I'm saying? Because this is all about the process.
What kind of vodka you want that screwdriver?
Just a Phillips. A little small Phillips. Yeah, just a small Phillips.
Phillips vodka?
Phillips screwdriver.
Oh, it says screwdriver. I thought you wanted a vodka screwdriver.
Well, I might need one after the show, that's for sure. All right, so we're just getting the thing down. We're not even worrying about how we're gonna try to paint Karen over here, or Miss Lolita, as she wants to be known here today on the show. And the reason why we're not worrying about it is we want to just sort of be mono-e-mono with the canvas and the paint. All right, great, Gus. Thank you. Great, that's great. And then the other side, too. Yeah, because I'll get paint on that. Jeff from Frozen Plastic. Thanks, Jeff. Okay. Now that we've begun. We got just a solid black yellow ochre field, okay? Now, with some paper towels or with a smaller brush, we can kind of map out what we're going to do here with Karen.
Awesome.
So we're going to just go from the waist up on Karen, most likely. I think we talked about this in the green room. And anyway, the size of the canvas only asks, you can only get so much on a canvas without, let's say if we wanted to try to get her whole body from top to head to toe, you're going to have this problem of, you know, you're not going to get enough paint and enough excitement, you know, in terms of form. with the paint. So let's keep it more straight ahead. Let's really get on with her face and get down further down and get some of her, get her breasts. And I think that, and then her hair. And I think, you know, that would be like, you know, then we can concentrate with the pinks that she's got on her skin and right. the lovely hair and stuff. So that's, I think that's our idea. Now, we can always change it up. I can always, with a whim of a paper towel, I can just wipe this baby right off. And but I don't have to right now because we're in the amoebic stages, if you will, of just beginning the process. We're not locked in, okay? But anyway, but we'll soon, over a period of time, begin to lock in. But right now, this is just a simple beginning, okay? Now, block in. What do we say all the time? Keep it simple and block in with big shapes. So what do I see? Okay, I can crop her off and I say, wow, that's a great shot too. That's a great pose. You're looking mean. You look like you just came off a motorcycle gang and you're gonna kick some ass, girl.
Yeah, the Hells Angels.
You are a tough SOB. No, DOB.
Right.
Okay. Daughter of a bitch.
Less.
Is that right? Is that?
Yeah, you know what?
Can you be that?
You know the saying, less is more?
Yeah.
I'm thinking we could get more if we do a little less. Just make my hair as long and blonde as you can, though, I think.
Well, we'll work on that. We'll work on that.
You don't have to throw in my shades, you know?
You don't think you want the shades?
Well, you know, I don't know. It's a toss-up.
Well, you know what? We don't get to that level yet,
okay.
Because what happens is that happens as we get on to the painting process. What we do now is those elements that you're concerned about, you know, like how you're going to be looked on in this canvas for future prosperity,
right.
That comes later in the show as we go further into the painting process. Because what I always try to instill in everybody is, well, many things, but one thing is, you know, don't be afraid of failing, but also, you want to keep it simple at the beginning and build up your paint, and at some point you start locking in, you start making those decisions, but it's later on.
Later on, yeah.
Right. So what
have you ever smoked grass doing this before?
You know what? I would like to amend my fifth element.
What an answer.
Okay.
That's so, all right.
Yeah, fair enough. Okay. This is a kiddie show, you know, for kids and stuff.
Yes, it is.
Yeah.
Kids that are...
And there's nothing wrong with seeing
kids that are growing up that mean.
Well, right.
You
but,
mean.
Yeah. Well, there's nothing wrong with seeing a naked person. I mean, we're all born naked. Let's of course, you're not going to see me naked, but that's a different story.
How come? It's all right. It's okay. Go on.
Yeah, let's not get into that. Okay. So now... I'm just sort of blocking in. I see, you know, this beautiful person in front of me, and it almost looks kind of strange. It looks like a penis, doesn't it? Well, that's just the way it goes because we're blocking in. Don't let those kind of things get in your mind too much. Otherwise, you might just stay there and draw penises all day. Don't let that be an issue. Okay, here's her hair, and I'm gonna just put some yellow here. But don't feel like we're just blocking in. Just keep that in mind. We're trying to feel where we're going. We're sort of seeking out how this is gonna work. How is this gonna work? Okay. Is this gonna work? I don't know. But we're just gonna keep going. We're gonna keep going and keep moving. Put some wonderful long locks, huh? Now, beautiful. A blue background is in the back, right? So let's put that in there.
Yeah, you practically read my mind.
The blue?
Yeah, it makes it.
Yeah, see? And so what we're doing, recap, and Jeff from Frozen Plastics on the side here playing some wonderful music. And
awesome name,
lovely,
Frozen
lovely
Plastic.
Lolita here is my model today.
Wait a minute. Okay, I got the shades.
I like the shades, but we don't have to stay with the shades. But I'm gonna put the nice blue background. But recap, da 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 da. Let's paint TV. Keep it simple, block in, and what have we done? We haven't really focused in on any kind of nuances of Miss Lolita. We've just only seen a woman with breast and hair. And that's all we're doing. We're keeping it simple. You keep it simple and you add later, okay? So now I'm gonna take this big brush and I'm going to kind of wipe it away to give the blue background. Now, I kind of feel sad and a little frustrated that I had to get rid of so much paint that was on this big brush. And that happens. It just happens. Sometimes you want to use all that paint that's there, and if you can mastermind how the paint goes from light to dark and from dark to light, you can avoid wasting paint. But I had to jump to the blue right away, so I am to get the blue background. We want to get that blue background in. So ultramarine blue, cobalt blue, what the hell, we'll put them together, see what happens. Not imperative to have just the blue. We're seeing a blue back there. Let's just get the blue. Now it's mixing with the yellow ochre, but there's not that much yellow ochre in there, and it's okay to go dark. As I've mentioned, in oil paints it's good to go dark, and then you can come back in and come back in with the light highlights. Okay, so that's what we can keep in mind. But again, we're just blocking in, we're feeling this out, we're feeling Miss Lolita out. I mean, and we have to take this approach. Now, this is an interesting thing. Yeah, we're painting a naked person, you know, and she's bearing it all. And, you know, I'm a little nervous about that. But I shouldn't be.
Don't be nervous.
Well, exactly. And that's what I'm here to prove, this is that this should be treated as a still life, as a landscape. Whatever you enjoy painting, like let's say you enjoy painting Transformers, or something like that, or horses, well, keep that idea of the freedom, the happiness that you have in that element.
Nakedness makes it.
And then just go for it. Just go for it. So
keyboards make it.
Keywords.
Keyboards.
Keyboards.
Just keyboards.
All right. I put a little ultramarine, alizarin crimson, and mix it with the ultramarine blue. That makes it kind of a purple. That's kind of neat. I don't know if I want to stay there with that, but I got my background in, okay? So now we're going to just go in there, and we can always refuel and add more stuff. Now, I got all this paint on this big brush, and we love on Let's Paint TV to use a big brush as long as possible. And so we're going to try that, okay? But if we feel like we have to, and we resort down to the smaller level, so be it. We can do that, all right? It's not the end of the world. If you're feeling it, go with it. You feel like you want to go small. But just remember, keep it in the back of your mind, big is beautiful. Big is beautiful. Okay, so I got that blue on that big brush, and it's on the side here, okay? Now, I want to get some of the dark feature, the dark reds that are on her skin, because now I'm going to start blocking in her face, okay? So let's go and try to make a pass. We're gonna come in like airplanes. We're gonna come in like little airplanes and give it a shot. We're gonna just try to do it, okay? So with this brush, it's gonna come in into the pan here with the ultramarine. You got that, Gus? You wanna get zoom in there, or are we gonna get that? Doesn't matter. Okay, so it comes into the juice can with the paint thinner, right? Boom, boom. I hit it in there. I still got the blue on the big brush, right? I hit my red, my alizarin crimson. I hit my red, okay? So now I'm getting a nice combo, and it's like I'm mixing the paint right onto the brush itself. Okay, so now I'm gonna come in. We're gonna come in, and here we go. All right, and I'm gonna squint my eyes. Okay, now I'm going alizarin, what's that color? Yellow ochre, to tone it down. And it's okay if we go a little dark with the skin. If we go, we can always push and pull. Go, you can exaggerate, and then we come back in with the lights. So that's what we're gonna do here. And you're not gonna know until you do it, until you make the mistakes. And then you fix the mistakes after analyzing it a little bit. But that doesn't happen until a little bit further down, when you've already gotten this, you know, you got to get further into it, right? So I'm
right. David Lee Roth called me an angel. He said that I'm only supposed to be pale.
Uh-huh.
And so I have all these other rock stars.
Right.
That come up to L.A., right? So
right.
I'm not actually supposed to have anything dark on me.
Well, you definitely.
I don't know.
See you as an angel. You right. are. You're an angel that's come into our viewers' lives today.
Right.
I now went from the red and I got there's some blue. Now this is an interesting thing because you look at the skin. Okay. Now, Karen, playing as Lolita, you see all that skin and you go, this is a white woman, right? Look at this white woman, right? But if you look at the skin, there's different colors in that skin. There's like a little bit of red, there's a little bit of blue. And you don't necessarily see that at first, but as you go on into the painting, you start to see it. So that's where I'm seeing in the shadows, I'm seeing a little blue around her breast there, okay?
Harrison, you got to remember something about art, though. I mean, everyday living, it's hard to wear the color red because...
Is that right?
Yeah, here's why. I know better than to wear the color red outside. It makes people, it makes straight conservative people hate you because they think you're a revolutionary, a communist, or somebody who wants to live it up too much, right? Because they're hypocritical, you know? They listen to AM stations.
Well,
you know, they're anti-Semitic.
I'm offended. I listen to AM stations, too.
Well, I know. I mean, there's some good things on it. I'm saying they listen to nothing but that, and they try and screw you
That's okay, isn't it?
No.
Sometimes?
No, I mean, take advantage of you.
Oh, okay. I was thinking of it in a different...
You know, you gotta watch the way you wear the color red, you know? I mean, they'll take you for commie, and they'll call me a prostitute, you know? Stuff like that.
Right, right.
They're that stupid.
Right, right. Okay. Well, that's very informative stuff, Karen Centerfold, as Lolita.
Right.
So, we're just plugging away, as you notice. Recap here, we got Jeff from Frozen Plastic and Karen Centerfold as Lolita, having a wonderful time as my guest portrait artist of the day. And a recap, block in, keep it simple with the big brush, and make those mistakes knowing that you can fix them. And we're going to show you how you do that, and that's mainly with this rag, this paper towel, okay? Now, this is always sometimes difficult. How are you going to paint your person, your model, when they've disappeared on you? But it's okay. It's okay. I trust that she'll be back. Also, you can sometimes work with your memory. But that's the thing. That's what we like to work with people who are actually live in front of you, as opposed to working from a photograph, because there's so many variables, and that's the fun part. This person is who she is. I am who I am. We're here 5 feet from each other. We're on TV trying to do a portrait of her. That's beauty. That is just, it's just, oh, whatever. It's what it is. That's what it is. It's not anything more than what it is. So, but the thing is, when you put that into your canvas, because you can't help it. You have to. There's nothing you can do about it but deal with it. And we're here. I'm dealing with it. I'm trying to capture this Lolita of Adelphia Cable.
I'm on every camera.
Well, today
I'm on E. I'm on MTV. I'm on this.
Okay, so I'm going to go with that big brush, and I'm just going all over the place. I'm having a great time. She's, you know, this is a great model to work with. I'd love to work with you some more here. This would be great. We can do a whole series of paintings, Lolita paintings. Okay, so. I'm going heavy, I'm going dark, and I'm using the big brush. At some point, I'm going to resort back to a smaller brush and maybe get some details, but not right now. Not right now. I'm kind of having fun with the process, okay? Let's go darker with the chin. That's a dark area. Now, there's a few areas on her face that are extremely dark because of the strong shadows. So let's try to at least apply some of that in there. okay? And around the eyes, usually it's usually dark, but it's not really dark. I mean, if we squint our eyes, it's not really, but we're just gonna do it anyway, because it feels good, and you kinda wanna just get moving. You wanna get moving, and things start to gel when you start moving, okay? Now, I'm gonna resort now to the smaller brush, okay? Let's resort to the smaller brush. And let's bring in some of her hair. Let's see what we can do with the hair. Get some more. See, because we just threw in some yellow. But wouldn't we want to have some more more oomph? And how are we gonna get
oomph?
We gotta get that oomph. And how are we gonna do that? And that's by applying a good amount of paint. What I do here too, we like to do, is get a lot of paint on there and then ask questions. And I like that philosophy for the sense of it just gets you going. Because if I had to stand here and go the regular route of drawing you, I'd have to say, okay, Karen, can you just stand there and stay right there, don't move? And then
Is that boring or what?
That's no fun.
That's so, not a horrible people like that. You're not that.
And I let Karen, I let, you know, I paint a lot of landscapes. They move. The sun moves. You can't control everything. And though, you know, we'd like to, I think, at times, and maybe I want to do that in my painting, but these variables are kind of fun.
Right.
Kind of fun. But then also, I'm not certain I'm gonna, you know, make a championship painting here.
Oh yeah.
I know. I warned you.
You could.
But I could. So big
and
brush.
You call it Lolita. That's the only thing that should be read on a painting like that.
Lolita.
Are the letters.
Lolita.
I mean, with this, you don't even really have to put the heart-shaped shades on me.
Okay.
I'm doing it. To be a turn on, you know?
Right, for TV?
Yeah.
Good. I'm going dark, as I have mentioned before, with the hair, but we can come back in with the light highlights, okay? Videl Sassoon is working with me to get a nice highlight color for paint, and that's in the process of Let's Paint TV factory over in La Cunada, the Let's Paint TV factory. Karen, what have you been doing over there? I wasn't looking, but I know something. Someone
just
was
concentrate on the painting. I'm doing a sort of a short workout to Jeff's awesome music, you know.
Oh, good, good. I think that will.
The trippier, the better, you know.
Definitely. We're just plugging away. I mean, there's, you know, painting shows can be kind of boring ultimately because it's just applying paint.
Hey, not here, not you.
Well,
what you do makes it.
We'll see. I mean, you know, it's unusual at the times, but, you know, at the end of the day, you know, it's still a painting show.
Right.
At the end of the day, it's another boring-ass painting show that you see on PBS, isn't it?
Not yours, no.
Well, that's what we want to hear. That's what we want to hear. Okay. Yellow hair. We're just staying in the hair. Gus, how are we doing with time? Johnny?
4 minutes left.
Oh, my God. Okay, but
we gotta make the best of it.
No, we're doing fine, and again, Karen, it'd be wonderful if we could have you stay another week so we can finish this portrait. Yes.
My boss would fire me. But we'll make some kind of arrangement.
Okay.
Right?
For Let's Paint TV. That's
right.
What we love about our guests that come on here. They love the show so much that they'll do anything to be on the show. And so anyway, we're having a great time here, TV. Did I say Let's Paint TV enough times so you guys know what the name of the show is?
It's a good name.
It's a great name. And Karen is having a great time, you know, as Miss Lolita. Now, who is Lolita? Can you give me a quick rundown on Lolita? What's
I'll
the story
tell you
on Lolita?
When you're done.
Oh, okay.
With the painting.
Oh, okay, because this is a program for kids.
Just say Angel. You say it just like that. It's my nickname. Angel.
Okay, Angel.
Yeah.
Good. All right. And so we're in the process, so we're kind of wrapping up in a sense, if there's only 3 minutes now. A quick rundown. What did we do this show? We stumbled, we fumbled, and we threw the paint down. And we had a great time checking out Miss Lolita, and we had Jeff over here from Frozen Place.
Awesome.
getting down with the vibe. We hope you enjoyed it too. And not that we're going to wrap up, but I just wanted to give you a rundown of how that worked out. We could always make that the end, but it isn't.
2 minutes, John.
2 minutes, okay. The main focus here is the blocking in. I don't know how much I want to stress this because next show, we're going to be more fine-tuned. We're going to really look at the skin color, the tones and stuff. But you're not, and we worked all over, didn't we? We worked the background, we worked her hair, we worked, but need, when you're painting like this, you want to get the paint down and ask questions later. And that's what we'll do next week on the Let's Paint TV show here. I'm your host, John Duff. If you want to talk to me, contact me. If you want to talk to Miss Lolita or Jeff from Frozen Plastic, you contact me at john@letspainttv.com. You want to be a guest on the show? You want to expose yourself to the world? You know who to contact. If you can't understand what the hell I'm talking about, there'll be some credits that are going to be rolling here in a sec. And I think we can get down here. I think we got a good beginning here. Now there's no guarantees, but we don't care about guarantees. All we care about is that we're creative and having a good time, and that we come back again and do another painting.
1 minute.
All right. That's the goal here. Is to make you feel like you can get back onto the horse and paint again, even though you failed and you didn't succeed. And with the tools that I offer, the big brush, all the time, you give us 22 minutes and we give you a big brush all the time. And I'll tell you what, you get more paint on the canvas, you get more spreading around, and you get more done, and then you can ask more questions. Block in, get your colors, and we'll see you next week. Some paint on the canvas and we have a good time. We don't worry about failing. We just have fun. Get a lot of paint on there. Ask questions later. Use a big brush. You know the spiel. Yeah, you do, don't you? You watch this show each and every week, don't you? We love it. We love it here at Let's Paint TV. We love making you guys feel creative. Because that's our mission. All right. Karen Centerfold as Lolita here tonight with us. She was here with us last week. Hi, Karen.
Hi.
How are you doing?
What's up?
What's up? You look a little slow and tired.
I am. I'm going to see my ex-boyfriend's concert tonight, Sky Saxon of the Seeds. I'm getting ready for that, and this is a good thing to get me in the mood for it.
Good for you.
I believe in art and this kind of form and rock and roll.
All right, but do you believe in crystal light?
Crystal meth? I never took it. Why?
No, crystal light.
Crystal light?
No, it was an old saying.
Oh, tell me about it.
Yeah, it was a jingle.
What kind of jingle?
If you believe in Peter Pan, you gotta believe in Peter Pan. Wait, no, crystal light. You guys know the story. You knew it. You were laughing. Crystal light. There's some jingle. You got me on the spot. Now I don't even know what it is. Say, everybody, let's say hello to Jeff from Frozen Plastic.
Yeah, Frozen Plastic.
Thank you.
All right, Jeff. Where's your Jeff?
He's on a plane somewhere. He's on a secret mission.
Okay. Well, it's just you. You're just doing solo duty here. Frozen Plastic here, the Let's Paint TV band. And, all right. Well, I guess I gotta start painting, don't I? Okay, so let's get my big brush out. Okay. Just a recap of what we did last week, okay? We had Karen here, sold as Miss Lolita. All right, when are you gonna take it off?
It starts getting hot in here, which is...
Let's turn up the heat. Johnny, turn up the heat, come on, I can't wait. Okay, let's get back to what we do here, and that is paint, okay, and dealing with all the variables that we have here in life, and this is just a microcosm of what we deal with in life, isn't it? Isn't it right? And that's the beauty of this show, and to be able to be creative with it, and to try to deal with all the variables and all the circumstances and happenstances that are amidst our daily lives. Anyway, last week we got into the process of painting Miss Karen Centerfold as Lolita, and we used a big brush the whole time. We blocked in, didn't we? We kept it simple, used a big brush for the most part. Then we got a little brush, but we mostly stayed with the big brush, and we just blocked in. We didn't worry about Karen jumping around, bouncing around. We didn't care about all that stuff. We just kind of got simple with it. We said, okay, I got some hair, I got a big head, and I have her breasts, and her background. We kept it to the simple things. And now, this week, we're gonna try to fine tune it a little bit, if possible. It is possible. And the only way to know is to dive in and get your feet wet, huh? Okay, so I have two choices, a big brush or a little brush. What should we do, John? I don't know. It's a decision. But it's a decision that you're gonna win no matter which choice you make, because we are equipped with failure relief medicine, and that is a way to wipe off your mistakes with paper towel. So when we come down to that, that's when we get to it. Okay, so I'm getting ready to paint Karen here, and do you like the way your face is like that?
Do you like the way my face is like that?
I love your face.
Fine. Just tell me to get in any position you want.
No, you don't have to. You kind of like the tilt to the...
To the
like,
side?
Yeah. That's a natural look for you. So I'll just maneuver my face, your face, that's on my painting here. Okay, we're actually going to paint now after about 10 minutes of jumping around, listening to the liquid stripes.
The white stripes.
The white stripes.
Right.
And this is liquid plastic.
Frozen plastic.
All right. Well, I'm screwing everything up. But that's just gives you an idea of the creative process, and that's what we want to show you, is that even though you fail and flub up, we still stay with the simple and true, and that is get some paint on the canvas. All right. So I'm just going to plug away. I'm going to begin plugging away. Plug, 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 plug. I'm using the smaller brush for the most part. Let's add some orange to your skin. Do, 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 all over the white. Do, 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 do. Do do. And now your nose is over there now a little bit more, and there is a stronger sense of shadow on this right hand side. You want to wear your glasses for the portrait, or do you want to take them? It's up to you.
I'll take them off, put them on. Take them off, put them on.
Okay, fair enough. Now, last week you were exposed a little more than you are this week.
I'll get naked pretty soon.
It's up to you. I don't want to push anything on you.
Okay.
So you like it like that?
Just lighter going all the way up.
All right. Well, let's just keep painting. Let's not worry about
colors. All right.
Yeah, and you know, if you don't feel comfortable, we don't have to put the breast in this week. We can put just the top.
Oh, yeah,
you want me to do that?
Oh,
well,
yeah.
Well, we're kind of waiting for you.
Okay. Then.
You want to just what? Stop tape or whatever? I mean, I don't. You know, sort of a sensitive
here
thing
we go.
Here.
I'm getting. I'm doing it.
Okay. I know it's kind of an awkward feeling. I'm not used to telling women to take their clothes off. So. In fact, I'm not going to look, okay?
I just wanted to try something new on, you know. All right, I'm ready. Okay?
Okay, great. Wonderful. Okay, so this is what we had last week. Karen's bearing it all, and we're dealing with that. And I'm dealing with that. And you, the viewing public's dealing with it, too. So... and we just have to plug away. Just plug away. It's just, think of it as a landscape. Think of it as a bouquet of flowers. And just go for it. I'm going to add some orange here. Now I'm noticing my brush is too small. And there's, my painting's a large painting. If I'm going to paint all day with this little brush, I'm going to be here all day. We can get much more done with the big brush. So we like to talk up the big brush as much as we can. So let's wipe away some of this dark. But before I do, let's just add some dark here and there that we see. And that's good. I like your angle. That's a good angle there. Wonderful. That's a nice angle. Getting a little sleepy there. Okay, good. It's a little, you know, portraits are kind of boring. You're just being sort of asked to stay there.
No, they're not. I was just up late last night.
Oh, okay, well. I didn't mean to refer to the fact that you were sleepy or bored.
I'm not.
Okay, anyway, clean my brush. You don't have to clean it so much, but with a paper towel, you can get rid of a lot of the paint. Come back into my juice can, get some paint in there. In fact, let's refuel. Let's put some paint thinner in here. Believe it or not, we're gonna have a nice painting here, I think. I'm sensing it, but it's good to have your tools in the right order sometimes. Sometimes it's good, sometimes it isn't. That's the beauty. There's so many variables here, and that's what we like, the invariables of doing things. Okay, so I cleaned my brush off pretty much with the paper towels. Now, let's just tell you something here. There's no right way to do anything here in painting. There's no right way to do anything in your life, all right? But this is the way I'm doing it. Fair enough? Okay, big brush, okay, and let's go for the skin. We're working her skin, all the beautiful pinks on her skin, okay? Now, do you want to stand like that more so? Because I think you're better off a little more, turn your torso, no, back. Yeah, that was better. But you can move your head that way, towards the monitor. Towards the monitor, that was good, that's good. Okay, yeah.
Is that perfect?
It's perfect, you are perfect. Okay, now I'm seeing the skin, you know, and we put blues in there, but now I'm working with the orange, all right? All right, so I'm putting it in there. Now, am I making a crucial mistake? I don't know yet, but we're working it out. We're putting, and you don't know until you start doing it, and that's the beauty here. So I'm gonna work the skins, the lights that I see on her breast, and then I'm gonna bring it up further up here, okay? And then we'll get the yellow hair going over the breast, but we're gonna go with the lights right now. And now at some point I'm gonna have to go with the light with the smaller brush, because this brush is too big to control. It's a little out of control. Go with more yellow, orange. Get the orange. I see more orange on the top part of her skin. And it's good to sometimes exaggerate, so that's what we're going to do. Orange up there. And I'm just going to go back over the eye section, because she's a wonderful, face, side of their face there. It's really, really kind of, you know, see what I did is I plowed through, but I'm observing. There she is, getting a little sleepy here. Got a big night ahead, Dia. Big night for you?
Yeah, I'm going to go see the Seeds. The Seeds rock band.
Yeah, yeah, I know. That's you on the cover, right? That's
yeah, with Sky Saxon.
Sky Saxon.
Yes.
Of the Seeds.
Uh-huh.
Cool.
The king of psychedelic rock.
All right. Now, see, I don't know anything about that stuff.
Number one.
Number one.
Sky Saxon.
Cool. Okay, so I've done a lot now with this big brush and blocking in. Let's see if we can get a line underneath her, this area here, underneath the breast, make some sense in the shoulders. So let's put that in there. And we're not locked in on this, but we're just gonna, you know, we're sensing that maybe that's what we want. Maybe the breast needs to go a little further down. I think they do, so let's bring them down. Bring them down a little further, okay? And these are things you just see. You're seeing this as you're going along. And we're right now we're sort of like in the bicycle motion. We're sort of just on the process. We've all know how to ride a bike, and we get to a level with the painting, we can just sort of feel like we're just painting. And it's just there. We see it. We're responding. We're observing and responding, okay? So there you go. Now, let's introduce the smaller brush, and let's put some details on her skin, on her, you know, bring back the nose. Let's bring back the nose. And Karen, if you could please go back to your original spot there.
Okay, wait a second.
Okay, time out. That looks good. Let's just do a little dance.
All right. Okay, like this.
Okay, good.
Like
yeah.
This.
Yeah, let me get your face. Let me just deal with your face now.
Okay.
But I didn't. I went back down to your breast. I don't know. Just happens.
Okay, that's cool.
It happens. Okay. Right. And it just, that's the beauty. You think that you're going to do something with that hand and the brush and the paint you got, and it just, something happens, and you just, it's intuitive what you do with your brush, and you just do it. And that's what we like to be. We like to get in that, like, mode of what's going on. So now, I'm running out of my dark blue, my ultramarine blue, and I went over my green. I have some phthalo green that makes a nice black, so that I'm going to resort to that. But I'm gonna start putting in some lines here. Here's her eyebrow here. Maybe a little too strong of an eyebrow, but we can fix it. And there, and get her those wonderful eyes that you have there. Look at that. Look at that. Oh, so cute. Look at that.
When I was just a little girl,
yeah,
my mother told me, what would you like to be?
I said,
que sera, sera. Whatever will be, will be. The future's not ours to see. I didn't know I was going to fall in love with rock stars and...
Uh-huh.
And idiots that took drugs. I don't know what it is about, you know, bands, artists, etc.
Uh-huh.
It's appealing.
Is it? Okay. So we're getting a little sensitive feel now. You know, like last week we blocked in and it made no sense. And now we gain the sensitive side of Karen. Centerfold, Miss Lolita, the sensitive feel. Okay, so let's put the eye, I'm gonna resort and put some eyes, the whites in your eyes. Let me do the whites of your eyes there. She's intently watching to make sure that I paint her just right. It's all quiet in the audience here. We do have a live studio audience, and they're captivated too. And you're welcome to be in the studio audience. I'm doing the lights, the highlights of her nose and all that, and we're just pounding away. We're pounding away. If I make a mistake, I can always come back, and I wipe it away, and fix it. Now, if you do too much of that, sometimes you get into this bogged down mode, and honestly, you're better off just moving on. Sometimes. Let's see, there's the lower part of the nose. Sometimes you make constant the same mistakes all the time, and I tend to make the lip area doesn't always jive for some reason, and I don't know why. It's just me. I got a lower lip. The lip area I always screw up, and I don't know. Now, see, I just did that with the big brush, and it didn't work out. And so I can wipe that away. But I have that paint on that brush, and I see her breast, and I see the wonderful colors, the blue that are there on the side there. So I'm going to bring that out more, okay? Because it's there. Why did you paint her breast blue? Because I see the blue. Her skin is white. You know, she's a white woman. But you don't just paint white. There's all these colors in there. Okay? So let me wipe that brush off, though, and give me some fresh lights on the side of her face there. Okay? And what we're doing here is you know, kind of making sure that the one side is light because of the element of the sun that we're
working with. Glory, glory, hallelujah for art. Just don't make my face look ugly, please. I know I'm saying something stupid. I know I'm saying something stupid right
now. No,
I know.
No,
I'm just so nervous. I want the painting to come out right. I want an art opening that I can have you come to with all your paintings and Jeff can play from the frozen plastic, you know.
Saran wrap.
I'm just real self-conscious. You got to make the face look pretty. Are you going to make it look pretty for Angel Karen?
Angel Karen, we're going to do our best. You don't want red lipstick, but you have red lipstick on you.
Yeah, I don't want red lipstick on it. I'm doing it for your show and for all the TV viewers because I'm just so fair.
Right.
And no red lips, no.
Okay.
Should be pink because that's what's in style, you know?
Right, right, right.
Red lipstick went out 45 years ago.
Is that right?
Yeah.
Now, you want me to put the eyeglass? I like to put your sunglasses in. I think that would be cool.
Okay, put it in, yeah.
I think that would be cool.
No, don't put it in because...
We'll take them off. There you go. Because then that way I can really get a better sense of
like,
what you're doing.
It's too... it takes away from the face too much.
Right. Wah, wah. Just keep you guys informed. You know, last week we were jumping around throwing down paint, and now we're doing a little bit of this fine-tuning on Let's Paint TV. Karen Centerfold as Lolita, Jeff from Frozen Plastic, trying to get your creative juices on. Karen's really nervous.
No, I'm not. That's all right.
Well, see, I'm aware that you're nervous, so that's putting into my thinking of, I got to do this correct. I can't fail. And, you know, sometimes that can make you set you up for failure because you're so concerned about failing. And I always like to say, I don't want to worry about that because ultimately, then you free yourself from the idea that you're failing. So there's nothing you can do. If you want the painting to look exactly like you, then you have someone, you know, who does that kind of work, works from photographs and the like. And this is more of an impression of Karen Centerfold. Now, if you don't want red lipsticks, should I give you orange lipsticks?
What's try pink. Pink is in.
Oh, pink. Okay, let's see.
Pink is eternal and it's in.
Okay, let's see if we can pull that off. It's so much easier to put red in, but...
That's red is
for... Oh, look at that. Look at that. Now it's looking cool. It looks like... you're pink. I see the pink. I see what you're talking about. Maybe I should start wearing pink lipstick. Do they got that for Blistex?
Mm-hmm. We forgot the whipped cream.
Ah, it's all right. You don't need that stuff.
To me, it'd be really cool.
Okay, so I've done a lot with your face, and honestly, we love to keep the things kind of fresh. So let's work on your hair. Now, I'm just going to have to, since your breasts have been taped because of TV programming restrictions, I'm just going to have to pretend I know where your nipples are.
Okay.
Just out of curiosity, where do you think they are in relationships to the tape? Are they about an inch above or On the crest, are they, the nipples, are they in the crest?
They're on the very end.
The very end,
yeah.
Okay. I'm just going to make an approximation of how I would assume that your nipples would look like.
Okay.
And... okay, so let's do that. What are we doing here? So probably a pink nipple. Nipples kind of
pink. Yeah, pink is cool.
Okay. I'm just going to put them here. I don't know if that's right. Just sort of my memory of what nipples, where they are on women's breast, I would assume they're maybe right there. Now, see, that's the beauty of working real loose with thick paint and gobby, is that you don't have to be so locked in to perfection. And that's what we like to do here, is to keep things fresh. And by doing so, you have a little more freedom, liberties to go ahead and make things that aren't necessarily anatomically correct and the like. Okay, now I bet you your breasts are even bigger than what I have. Let me see if I can bring them even more. I got a feeling that this is working out just right. Now, let's work on your hair. I think your hair needs an update.
You can say that again.
What do they call that?
They call it an overly dyed thing, is what they call it, from taking too many trips, getting a bit of sun.
Uh-huh. Is that Southern California thing, right? Just too
exactly.
much sun down here? So I'm going to have some of the hair come down onto your breast, overlapping.
Can they put on another film, like one of those other films, while we do this? Oh, that's looking much better.
Thank you.
Yeah, could you put on that biker film or some... Yeah, thank you.
Yeah, put a biker film on.
Oh, no, that's fine. They put that India flick on.
Okay, now sometimes it's good to get away, and we're doing this fine-tuning thing, and sometimes, you know, things just aren't... Well, what did I tell you before? We always talk about this, and that is... Because I'm at that stage of trying to be fine-tuned, Mr. Fine-Tune. And sometimes you just have to throw that out the window and tell yourself, we're not here to be Mr. Perfect. We're here to experience the Karen Centerfold experience. We're here to experience Jeff playing the music, being on TV, in my case. In your case, you're watching. We're here to experience it. We're not here for perfection. So with that in mind, free yourself. So much about this perfection thing. You're looking good, Karen. You're looking hot. Look at that hair. It's very flowing. Do you get that professionally done, or do you take care of that hair yourself?
I do it.
Do you find most have it professionally done, or?
Depends.
Yeah. Do you have a need, you know, because the idea of having it done, I mean, if and when you do it, are you more inclined to, like, go to Beverly Hills to get it done? Because it's set, or
Melrose? No.
No? I'm done with the questions now. Jeff, you have any questions for Karen? No, I'm just kidding. I felt like a question and answer period here. You know what? We're running out of time, but you know what, Karen? I honestly think that we basically captured the essence of Karen Centerfold.
Yeah, I hope so. In the flesh.
In
yeah,
the flesh. Good. And, you know, what can I say? I think, you know, I'm basically done with the idea of today's show. And that was... and having a good time, which is what we do each and every week. Last week we had fun blocking in, not getting all uptight. This week we tried not to get uptight, but then there was that moment of getting uptight, and that's sort of where we are at the moment. But we freed ourselves. We put it on, on the side of our head, and we said, you know what? Loosen up, John, loosen up. Thanks so much. Thank you, Karen Centerfold.
You're welcome.
We'll see you on TV. And Jeff from Frozen Plastic.
Thank you.
We'll see you next week. If you got questions, you want to be a guest on the show, contact me at john@letspainttv.com. We'll see you next week.